Hello everyone, welcome to Apti Plus Academy for Civil Services. This is the video on daily topic wise news analysis where we cover the news from two important newspapers, that is the Hindu and Indian Express. So let's get started with the topic first. So these are the list of the topic for the day. Today is 6th of October. The first topic is algorithm transparency. The second topic is squad beating. Third, the GST compensation, the recent meeting which was held. The fourth topic is India give Myanmar the remdesivir drug. This is an important news regarding the India and Myanmar relationship. And the last topic is reimagining the education system. Apart from all this topic, I'll be discussing some MCQs question at the end of this video and the explanation of yesterday questions. तो जो कल के सवाल थे उसके correct options और explanation दोनों मैं आपको बताऊंगा. So stay tuned till end of this video. And those of you who have appeared for this year prelims examination and are very comfortable, like they are getting somewhere 100 plus, so they can join without any delay the mains assessment program. This is the mains test series for CSE 2020. So this is something which is very important at this point of time, so that there is paucity of time when it's come to the mains examination. So what you can do, you can write as many as test so that they can have a grasp of the paper. And for the student, for the aspirants who are like lacking somewhere, like they're like 95 or below 90 and they are preparing to appear for 2021, so we have the mock test series aligned which you can join and definitely boost your concepts, right? So for more details, you can check the description of this video where I have given the link of the both the initiative. You can check more details and register from there. Now coming to the first topic, that is algorithm transparency. This is there from the Indian Express. This talks about the recent, basically the dialogue which was there known as Race 2020. So this would be important for the general studies paper 2, and equally it would be important for the prelims examination. So in the recent inaugural function, which was named as Race 2020, the Prime Minister has laid focus on the following things, that he wanted that India should be a global hub in terms of the artificial intelligence, the AI. जब बात करते हैं AI की, तो India is a country which has a huge potential when it's come to the artificial intelligence. तो उसी को लेकर के बातें कही गई है. And Race 2020 is a global AI summit being organized by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Right? तो ministry अगर पूछी जाती है आपसे, तो you can quote that this is the particular ministry, because any initiative would rather be very important with its ministry concerned or the nodal offices concerned. Now coming to the advantages of the global AI summits, what are the advantages, what how it could pay India in coming years. So the 5-day event was the inviting global experts from the countries, and it deliberate the AI as a social empowerment. AI has a multiple dimension. It has to be used in the field of agriculture, uske alave healthcare, educations, smart mobility. So these are some of the area where AI has a potential, right? And one of the focus of the global virtual summit would be leveraging the power of AI in the pandemic preparedness. जो भी COVID-19 की pandemic है, उसके preparedness को किस तरह से और boost कर सकते हैं. So this would be something, a potential power of the AI. And artificial intelligence ecosystem is going to promote a large pool of skilled professional who will be there to manage the AI system and the world, right? So this would be the huge power of the and advantages of the AI. Now the summit called for the regulation, a sound regulation framework which would protect the data by clarifying the national resources and protects its privacy, because it is very important. If AI is there, a privacy has to be maintained and all the securities that has to be ensured should be in place, because we do not have basically data laws ki agar baat kare, data privacy laws ki baat kare, to India mein still we do not have the stringent law or koi bhi strict rules abhi nahi hai. Now coming to the area of focus by the Prime Minister. So the Prime Minister has stressed on the need for transparency and accountability to protect against the weaponization of technology by the non-state actors, right? So this is a very important point. Now second, what he said, that it remain our collective responsibility to ensure that how the AI is being used. So this basically means the ethical use of the AI, right? So ethically it should be very sound, and the algorithm transparency is key in establishing the trust, right? Through algorithm transparency, a trust would be maintained across the globe. And it is equally important that the entity, the people concerned, the stakeholder, the state, the member should hold its accountability, right? Accountability would be again the key components of it. And Prime Minister has focused that we must protect against the weaponization by the AI to the non-state, which I have told you here, right? So these are some of the area of focus by the Prime Minister himself. Now the second topic is again from the Hindu Quad meeting. This is a very important news which has been there continuously. It has been there in the news. So Quad is again important for the prelims examination, and this type of news can again help you in your general studies paper too, right? Where it comes to international relation or any summits, it can be important there as well. Now external affairs minister ki meeting hui hai. Basically jo hamare India ke external affairs minister S. Jaishankar, he will meet his counterpart of Australia, India, Japan and United States, right? So this would be a collateral meeting in Tokyo. So this is also known as Quad, right? And the meeting is seen as a significant turning point for the grouping led by the growing concern over the China region, right? So what China is doing, they are trying to dominate the region, talking about the South China Sea. This is again something which is very important. And the other part, the dominance in the any other neighboring countries, that would be inevitably very important for India. So the growing of China in the region around the neighboring countries as well as in the Indo-Pacific region has a huge concern for the other members country. Now coming to the agenda of the meeting, jo ye meeting ho rahi hai uski kya agenda hai. So the first is the cooperation on the 5G connectivity, because 5G is something which is very important. China has a huge advancement when it's come to 5G. US mein bhi cheeze placed hai. Abhi aapko pata hoga US mein jo civil war hui hai US aur China ke beech. So like Huawei has been banned in United States and they have invested a lot in the 5G technology. So this is something India still is waiting for the 5G technology. We do not have the confirmation from the ministry when the 5G would be there in India, right? And the second, the agenda of the meeting was cyber security, supply chain initiative for manufacturing, because India is more focused on the manufacturing. Make in India initiative is again not very much successful, but through Atmanirbhar Bharat, India is more focusing on the manufacturing sector. Maritime cooperation would be the fourth agenda of the meeting. Infrastructure and connectivity is something which would be again very important. And the last would be distribution plan for the COVID-19 vaccine in all areas, right? It would be alternative to the Chinese initiative that would be discussed. So these are some of the core area agenda of the meeting that is going to be discussed in the Quad meeting. And Quad is scheduled to be held today itself, right? Today is Tuesday, so it is scheduled for today. The other part of the meeting that is also very important, that the meeting will begin a regional assessment including the development in the South and East China Sea, which I have told you in the beginning. So the South, basically 6 month standoff was also there in the line of actual Katoni, the Eastern Ladakh region. So this has hugely impacted India. Hamare ko isse bahut zyada chhati hui hai. And Hong Kong and Taiwan, where China is aggressively moving as a most marked. So in dono country ko China se bhi problem hai. So these all are the global problem that has to be discussed in a single platform, that is Quad, right? So Quad would be again very important. So you should remember that Quad as a multilateral forum would be again very important. The four ministers will hold a discussion. They will, the important issues will include the Australia and the next edition of the Malabar naval exercises, because Australia has been there in the Malabar exercise previously as well. That is scheduled to be held in the November, right? And India will also had discussion in the other Quad countries that can help in building the east-west connectivity from India to the ASEAN countries. So these are some of the other agenda that would also be discussed in the meeting of the Quad, right? Now coming to the other news, that is GST compensation. I had already discussed a news yesterday and I've told you that we'll be discussing the outcome of the meeting. So the outcome of the meeting is there. So basically this would be again important for your general studies paper 3 and equally important for your prelims examination, right? So the 42 GST council meeting has failed to reach any consensus in compensating the state because the demand of the state has been lot pending. काफ़ी टाइम से स्टेट ने डिमांड किया हुआ था कि उनके जो पेंडिंग सेस हैं जीएसटी के वो उनको मिलने चाहिए, बट स्टिल इट्स अ लॉन्ग ईयर, ऑलमोस्ट ईयर एंड हाफ इट हैज़ बीन पेंडिंग. And the differences between the state ruled by the non-NDA and the center over the plan to get the state borrow, right? What center is doing, center ne force kiya hai ki states ko borrow karni chahiye amount, but none of the states are agree, especially Kerala ne completely is cheez ko deny kiya, right? And the estimation is around 2.3 lakh crore in the shortfall of the compensation that has to be collected this year, right? एंड द मेजर शॉर्टफॉल हैज अगेन बीन कंटिन्यूड. मैं आपको आगे नंबर बताऊंगा क्या है. तो मीटिंग के आउटकम समझ लेते हैं. व्हाट आर द मीटिंग आउटकम्स. सो द काउंसिल डिड नॉट एग्री टू एक्सटेंड द लेवी ऑफ कंपनसेशन. इट हैज नॉट एग्रीड कि जो सेस द लेवी ऑफ द सेस वुड बी एक्सटेंडेड अंडर द जीएसटी रिजीम बियॉन्ड द फाइव ईयर पीरियड दैट इज 2022. इसके आगे कोई भी टाइम इट वुड नॉट बी एनवेसाइज्ड. एट इट वॉज एनवेसाइज्ड इन द ओरिजिनल जीएसटी रिजीम की दे वुड बी इनिशियली गेटिंग फॉर 2022. तो इस टाइम तक ये फिक्स रखेंगे इसको. दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू इंक्रीज इट. And the compensation requirement by the states between the April and July stoods up to 1.5 lakh crore rupees. So this is the amount that is immediately needed to the state's government, right? And the total cess collection can be used to repay the borrowing made by the year and compensation shortfall, and it will remain for such period to be required to meet the revenue gaps, right? The GST Council has decided to extend the surcharge on the luxury goods like tobacco and other parts beyond June 2022. So, जो luxury items होंगे उन पे जो basically जो कम जो cess है उनको 2022 से आगे भी continue रखने की बात कही गई है, right? And the center will meet again in October 12 to resolve the issues. एक बार फिर से meeting होगी and they would decide what to do, right? So, like they will release 45,000 crore rupees as a GST due to the state by the next week to immediately help the spending need amid the pandemic, right? So this is something which was the main outcome of the meeting. Now coming to the other news, that is India gave Myanmar the remdesivir drug. This is an important news reported both in the Hindu and the Indian Express, but we are considering the Indian Express news. So this is important for your general studies paper 2, where international relation section is concerned, and this would be more important for your mains only, right? Prelims se yahan pe koi sawal jo hain wo important nahi honge. So as a part of the contribution to help our friendly neighbor like Myanmar, India has given 3000 vials of remdesivir drugs to the Myanmar to fight against the COVID-19, and the package of 3000 vials of the antiviral remdesivir drugs would ensure safe, sustainable and speedy return of the Rohingya's refugees, because Rohingya issues is again long pending in Myanmar, right? India ke saath bhi kaafi lekar ke issues hain Rohingya ko. So that is something which is very important at this time of the COVID-19, and operationalization of the crucial Sweety port in the Myanmar, that is in the Rakhine state of March 2021. So Sweety port is again very important. I will tell you the importance of this port. And the Indian side had expressed an appreciation to Myanmar for holding 22 cadres of Indian Surgeon Group in May this year, right? So what are the other points that they have discussed? Because this was a meeting that was held between the part of the summit that was going to be held. So this came, the visit came 2 days after the two countries have given a detailed and the wide virtual meeting that was held under the framework of India-Myanmar Foreign Office and the consultation. So ये discussion चल रही थी, इसको देखते हुए सारी चीज़ें decide की गई हैं. So the safe return of Rohingyas from Bangladesh to Myanmar is expected. और जो foreign level की जो secretary और India के जो army chief है to the Myanmar, इन दोनों के बीच में कुछ बातें हुई हैं जिन पर ये decide किया गया. And India and Myanmar are working towards the operationalization of the Sweety port, right? First quarter में Sweety port पर भी काफ़ी ज़्यादा development पर ध्यान दी जाएगी. And it is a port as a part of Kandalan multimodal transit transport system, right? Which is being viewed as India's gateway to the Southeast West. So India को Southeast West में enter करने के लिए Sweety port एक बहुत ही बड़ी, बहुत ही निर्णायक बेसिकली एक साबित हो सकती है, सफलता साबित हो सकती है, राइट? सो दिस वुड बी अ ग्रेट अचीवमेंट फॉर द इंडिया इफ दे डू दिस. एंड द पोर्ट विल कनेक्ट इंडियाज लैंडलॉक्ड नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन, बेसिकली अगर बात करें बे ऑफ बंगाल या मिजोरम के थ्रू निकलने को. सो दिस इज द समथिंग विच वुड बी प्रोवाइडिंग अ ग्रेट अल्टरनेटिव, एंड इट हैज़ अ ह्यूज इम्पैक्ट, राइट? बहुत ही पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट हो सकते हैं इसके इन टर्म्स ऑफ ट्रेड एंड कॉपरेशन. Now the last topic of the day, that is reimagining the education. So this is something which has been reported in the Hindu. आपको editorial page में चीज़ें मिल जाएंगी. This is important for your general studies paper 3 per se, education is there. And it is also important for your general studies paper 2, policies की अगर बात करें तो वहाँ पर सारी चीज़ें काफ़ी important है. Now national education policy is as good as it is actual in the practice. This is what the author has to say in the article. And it would be an ideal to explore the contours of the national education practice, because by 2047, we'll be becoming India's independence of 100. It would be celebrating 100 years of the India's independence. So this is something which would be very important for India. And per se, talking about the education, this is something which has to take a new leaps, right? So from a teacher's perspective, the new education practices can be viewed through the following designs of the principle. So kuch panch important principle bataye gaye hain, jinke design pe ye cheeze kaam karegi. Wo panch principle kaun kaun se hain, wo main aapko bataunga. So the first is the to key is excel, right? To excel is the key. How to excel? In excel in terms of autonomy, excel ki baat ki gayi hai autonomy ke terms mein, jis tarah se Indian Institute of Management Bill 2017 mein pass ki gayi thi to get IIMs and autonomy. So this is inevitable, very important. And the greatest insurance of the autonomy is the excellence of the student outcome rather than the piece of legislation, right? जो भी ऑटोनॉमी मिलेगी इंस्टीट्यूशन को, वहाँ स्टूडेंट्स को परफॉर्म करने के लिए अच्छा मौका मिलेगा, राइट? अपार्ट फ्रॉम द पर्पस ऑफ द लेजिस्लेशन, प्रैक्टिकली इट विल बेनिफिट द स्टूडेंट कम्युनिटी. एंड देयर विल बी ऑटोनॉमी इन टीचिंग मेथड्स, ऑटोनॉमी इन द लर्निंग एंड क्रिएटिंग द ओन करिकुलम, एंड ऑटोनॉमी थ्रोट्स थ्रू द सेल्फ गवर्नेंस, राइट? सो दीज आर समथिंग दैट वुड बी अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ टेक्नोलॉजी रिच सेटिंग. Learning in 2047, 6 billion students, people would be there in the world. That would constitute the medical class. जो middle class हैं, उसके जो numbers होंगे, वो 6 billion होने वाले हैं आने वाले time पे, right? And the technology will proliferate. जो intelligence technology है, चाहे वो बात करें software की, वो सारे जगह पे पहुँचेगी. जिस तरह से lockdown के बाद people are more inclined towards the smart classes, the smart technology, online classes. So it will proliferate more, right? Smart school, smart classes may soon be morphed to the smart chair and the smart desk. And the four core tasks of the university would be, first, the creation, second is dissemination, third is accreditation, and fourth is monetization. So this is something, these are the four components around which the technology rich institution would be working. And the knowledge would require as a sweet synthesis of the algorithm and the altruism, right? So these are some of the important points under the technology and rich settings. Now coherence across the fields. So how the coherence would be there? So coherence in terms of the transdisciplinary. So the new national education policy roots in the multidisciplinary institution rather than the standoff schools, right? और जो मल्टीडिसिप्लिनरी होगी, दैट विल इन्वॉल्व द एक्सपर्ट फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट वर्किंग टुगेदर, ईच ड्रॉइंग फ्रॉम देयर यूनिक डिसिप्लिनरी नॉलेज, राइट? हाउएवर 2047 की अगर बात करें, देन ट्रांसडिसिप्लिनरी रादर देन द मल्टीडिसिप्लिनरी विल बी द नॉर्म. और जो ट्रांसडिसिप्लिनरिटी है, इज अबाउट क्रिएटिंग द कोहरेंस ऑफ इंटेलेक्चुअल फ्रेमवर्क एंड बियॉन्ड द डिसिप्लिनरी पर्सपेक्टिव. सो दिस इज द थर्ड कोहरेंस इन टर्म्स ऑफ द फील्ड. द फोर्थ इज as a connecting hub. School is a connecting hub. किस तरह से school को एक connecting hub बना सकते हैं? Through technological innovation. So what will happen? The content of the knowledge has evolved in the text and it can be cognized into the visual, audio and tactile as an immersive experiences. अभी होता है क्या, सिर्फ आप offline classes जाते हो तो वहाँ पे सिर्फ आपके पास visual, audio visual होती है, right? Tactile immersive experiences अगर बात करें technology के through या कुछ ऐसे pictorial graphics के through, 3D animations के through, तो ये सारी चीज़ों को भी include किया जाएगा. Now disruptive innovation would enable technology to give the greater access, right? And this would again fulfill the knowledge at the need of the learner, right? And learning school of the world would harness the talent and technology seamlessly. So technology ke saath adopt karna, usko puri tarah se daily life mein include karna would be inevitable. It would be very easy and that would be the need of the hour by 2047. So we are talking at the age of 2047 where India would be celebrating its 100 year. Now nurturing the mind with values. So for this we need to have a value mindset and culture. So by 2047, India's teacher will be engaged in nurturing the global mindset based on the three classical value system, that is Satyam, called as authenticity, Nityam, called as sustainability, and Purnam, that is wholeness, right? So ye teen cheez pe kaam ki jayegi. And the mindset will be based on how learner receive the information and not what the information they received, but how to think rather than to what to think. So this is something which important. The most valuable outcome of the education is becoming a component and compassionate human being. So ultimately at the end, the valuable part is that the education should ensure that the individual is coming with a well human being. So humanity has to prevail. This is the main motive behind the education system, right? You should be a well human being. Now this was all article. Now coming to the answers, jo kal ke sawal the, uske correct options main aapko bataunga. So the first question, the correct option here is C, and the explanation is both the statement are correct. Tax haven countries have the low or near zero tax rate, especially some of the kind of transactions, and the tax haven also share the limited or no financial information with the foreign tax authorities, right? So this you can find in the business line. You can just type in the Google about the tax haven, you will get the link, you can read more about that, right? Now coming to the second, the correct option here is B. The statement one is correct, that the governor appoint the state election commissioner and determine his condition of the service during the tenure of the office. And two is incorrect, that he appoints the chairman and the member of the state public service commission. However, they can be removed only by the president and not by the governor, right? So for more details, you can refer to the Indian Polity by M. Lakshmikant, where all the details are given. It's when it's come to the governor power or governor exclusive power, the chapter is dedicated to the governor. You can read more details from there. And if the time being, let's come to the MCQ's question of the day. The MCQ's question, first question is coming from the Polity. Consider the following statement with regards to Prime Minister. The term of the office of the Prime Minister is not fixed and he holds the office during the pleasure of the President. This is the first statement. Now the second statement, the salary and the allowances of the Prime Minister are determined by the President. So what you have to do, you have to simply write A, B, C, D as your answer. Choose the correct option and write your answer in the comment section down below, right? Second question is from the Indian Economy. Consider the following statement with regards to GDP deflator. GDP price deflator measures the difference between the real GDP and the nominal GDP. And the nominal GDP include the inflation while the real GDP does not include the inflation. So GDP deflator is an important concept. If you have any additional information, that also you can share with us in the comment section, or you can simply write the correct option. Whatever you feel is the correct option, you can write in the comment section down below. So do participate, write your answer in the comment section. And if you are new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe Apti Plus on the YouTube, where we'll get the more informative videos with regards to the examination. And if you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up, right? And if you have any other concern, do let us know. We'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Wish you all the best. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.